Hello, Internet. It's me, Hugh, with another Geek Diary for you. It is the first Monday of September, which makes it Labor Day, which makes it the end of summer, the end of freedom, and the beginning of school. At least that's how I remember it. Of course, now I'm a parent, so it's kind of a little bit reversed. But I wanted to find out what Labor Day really, really meant. So what I did was I went on the interweb and I started doing some research, and as one does when one delves into the history of things, one finds murder, mayhem, and massacre, and I have found it here. Because Labor Day is a celebration of the workers of the world, the working class that built great countries like America and Canada and 80 other countries that also celebrate Labor Day. I'm not sure what the other ones are doing, but there you go. So that's basically what Labor Day is. Now that sort of makes sense to me, except that I found out that it was supposed to be celebrated in May, not September. The reason it got moved was because in 1886, in Chicago, there was a peaceful demonstration and a strike working for, labor was striking for an 8-hour workday, and they were demonstrating this sort of police brutality that happened in previous days. Very peaceful, everything's going fine until someone in the crowd hurls a homemade dynamite bomb at the police, blows up a policeman, starts a gunfight, fires, mayhem, and basically an international incident. So much so that the president at the time, Grover Cleveland, I love that we had a president called Grover. It's just a Grover thing. It's a Sesame Street thing. I love that image. Anyways, so Grover Cleveland decides, wait a sec, we cannot celebrate Labor Day in May because people may associate that with this terrible Haymarket Massacre. So what they do is they pick it up and they plunk it down in September, far, far away. So no one will make that association. Of course, we have now. And so that is why we celebrate Labor Day in September. And that's a little bit of history for you about it. And as I say, when in doubt, get on the interweb, check out this history stuff, because it's always the most sordid, gruesome thing. So, until we geek again, cheerio!